Okay, folks, this is Sturge here at Fort Lahar here on Calypso. Doing just about to finish the Fort Lahar cleanup, which is some of the new content here on Calypso. I think it's great. It's amazing. One of my one of the best updates I've seen since I've been playing. Year and a half. I know, not long. Year and a half. That's funny, isn't it? But yeah, this is great. This little deal right here, screenshot. I think that's probably one of the coolest things in this new update. This is Fort Lahar, which replaces Fort Isis. Probably for good reason. Because the connotation for the name Isis now has changed. Those of you who remember Fort Isis, it really was a pain. It was difficult to play the upper version versus the lower version. It was hard to get from the bottom to the top and the top to the bottom without falling for the ladder. It was quite annoying. And the mobs were different. They were mixed mobs. It was, what a pain. So I'm kind of glad that's gone. I shouldn't say kind of. I really am happy that's gone. This is a new instance that's a lot more fun. This is a new area that's a lot more fun. That has the robot instance. Where the robots attack Fort Lahar. Kind of hoping I finish my curbs part of this before... before those robots attack again. Even though that's a lot of fun, it's definitely it's a ped sink. It's a moneymaker for, certainly for Mind Arc. Twice a day, it appears that people will just throw the ped at it. Shoot all those, all the different, 16 waves, I believe, of robots, plus the warlock at the end, level 123 warlock at the end. I'm not really complaining about that, even though, Mind Arc's making money. The other, just 2 days ago, there was a, I came over here to Fort Lahar, and, I was part of the fight, and, one of the, I think, level 27 troopers that we were shooting, hoffed for a little over 1,000 ped. And there, I think there were only 4 or 5 of us shooting the darn thing. So I ended up with, 112 ped gun from that. And then not just 2 robots later, it was a 500 ped global. And I got another 100 ped gun out of that. And then there were probably 2 or 3 other small globals. I maybe only picked up a few ped off of each one of those, maybe 4 or 5. But then I went back and finished my XSRs. Actually, I'd finished XSRs before. Then I went worked on Kabibos. No globals off the Kabibos. In fact, the loot was good, but not global level. I still managed to come out ahead. And... now I'm doing Kerberos, and I've been globaling off these guys just left and right. 10s and 12s, which is pretty normal for these. But I did hit a 47 peg global off the curbs yesterday. And at the end of this video, I'm going to include the 34 peg global that I just hit maybe 5 minutes ago, 10 minutes ago, something like that. But I'm almost done. I don't want to get this finished. But I want to cover some topics. This new area is outstanding. There's some cross over here. You've got Kerberos, the Iron Kerberos Challenge. It's just that I'm on stage 3. If I don't die here, let's just heal real quick. Yeah. I'm on stage 3. Each Kerberos provider gives you 15 kill points. It's pretty sweet, right? That's not a lot of kill points, but it's kill points nonetheless. 200 of those is 3,000 skill points. which is stage 2. So, as you can see, I've already run out of stage 2. We're on to stage 3. And that's the curbs for you. So, that's kind of nice. That's a great way to do some crossover. Let's see. Not bad. Ooh. Is he farting? Kerberos farts. 2 left. 2 remaining. And then I'll cover some different topics here. Why I came to Calypso, even though in the last video I posted, I said I was actually going to Arcadia. Well, I didn't do it, obviously. I came here to Calypso to gain skills, and I've done just that. Which is exactly what I need to be doing. I need to be playing to gain skills and make money, right? Make paid. Because someday, you know, I'd like to be awesome enough to withdraw from said game, that which I put in, then play with the house's money for the rest of the time. I think that's a doable scenario. But here we are, Fort Lahar, doing the cleanup, trying to finish up the curbs, and get this guy out of the way. Not hitting it. It's too bad. Alright, 1 remaining. Quick heal. Let's see, which guy do you think? I am using my Z12 Barbarella from my gold pack that I purchased some time ago. It is amped. The amp that is provided when you purchase the gold pack here. Okay, what are we at here? So 5.5 to 11 damage. That's not bad. This is a tier 1.6 unit. Fort Lahar here, great place to be. This has turned out to be a bit of fun. I'm really enjoying most of the aspects of the this update. Certainly the screenshot, which tells you, oh look, we saved this file here for your screenshot. 12 for every 100. One of the nice things about there we go. Done. Not much. I am I'm a big proponent of N plus 1, so 200 kills. I always like to do one more, just because I feel like maybe I screwed something up. So here we are out here, finished up that. We should be able to get the... I don't know if we got the armor piece from them. Doesn't appear that we did. That's the reward for the Fort Lahar cleanup, is this armor plate. Hopefully we'll go get that here in just a minute. Actually, I can see. I gotta go over here to this guy and shut him up. One of the other things I want to cover is why I came to Calypso in the first place, and it was to buy and to actually harvest trees. We're gonna have to do N plus 2. In the skills you get with the Terra Tech PH Personal Harvester 1 through 3, they're amazing. That's the way to play this game. If you want to get skills for really reasonable cost, you buy that. You buy the Personal Harvester, the PH1 from the trade terminal. It's 5 ped, and you get all kinds of skill games. Botany, zoology, alertness, especially a ton of alertness, but this, the most important one is perception. And I can't stress this enough, the perception gains, I've gone from about just shy of 800 perception points to over 1400 perception points. And that's just in the last month. That's just prior to this update. This new content update. Which, well, heck. Nothing there. Ped. Good to go. We're out. That's pretty amazing. I see on the forums a lot of people, and certainly in game, people saying, "Ah, how do I gain perception? How do I gain perception?" Buy the PH1, the personal harvester one from the trade terminal. Go out south of Camp Icarus, find those level 1 through 3 trees, and harvest them. And you're going to get those perception gains, especially if there's a little bit of a bonus, so not just cutting the bare minimum. Harvesting the bare minimum from the trees. If you're going to get, let's say, a level 1 tree, instead of one log, you're going to get, I don't know, anywhere up to 30 per harvest. That's really the key. And that's where you're going to get that perception gain. There's a lot more to it. All right, let's see. Do we get the? Let me get back to the personal harvester after I talk to this guy real quick. Mr. Scout, here you go. 7 robot alloy armor plates. Oh, 7 of them. Oh. Well, heck, I thought it was just one. That's totally worth it. By dragging and dropping it on the piece of armor. Sure. This is an L item. It's worth 2 ped. Each. 2 ped a piece. These are L, so it doesn't matter. But look, we got some penetration, impact, and burn. Nice. Cool. Well, so then that makes some sense. Why not give you a bunch of these, and then while you're fighting the robot incursion, you can wow, that's 14 ped. That's pretty cool. Let's take a look at these guys here. Oops, armor. 6, 7, cool. Oh, hot dog. I like it. Fort Lahar cleanup. That was definitely worth it. Okay, talking about personal harvester. Let's get back to personal harvester here. I came to Calypso to gain skills using my Terratech, the trade terminal one. And I've got some special places where I go and harvest trees that are really nice. I have tons and tons of trees. And when I got here, this is probably 4 or 5, maybe 7 or 8 days before the update. I'm going through a bunch of these. I'm gaining skills, I'm gaining skills, and I'm in this area, and I get 12 perception gains within like 6 trees. So probably 2 per tree. Actually, one tree gave me 4 or 5. And it was a, I was using the PH1. And I thought to myself, well, why? I'm not really getting extra. I mean, I'm losing money, but I was only getting like a return of 4.8 ped per 5 that I put out. So 20 peck loss for those skill gains is amazing. Then it occurred to me, it's because there were level 2 and level 3 trees. They're everywhere. So I bought the PH3. And the markup was, I think, see, yeah, about 0.5 ped then, it was almost a month ago. Think. Yeah, that sounds about right. Anyway, so total cost about 80 ped. And this is an unlimited Terratech PH3, so it works really well. And I went out and started going back to my favorite forest and using that, and I was still getting the perception gains, but I was able to harvest the level 1, 2, and 3 trees for their various short moonleaf, and long moonleaf boards, and their values. And then the values weren't very good. They were 105, 108, and like 140% markup, respectively, short. The regular and then the long moon leaf boards. And then the update came. And the reason I mention this is because it's right place, right time. And what happened? It's the gardening update. And everybody wants to build their snugs on their property that they purchased, their plots that they purchased. And to do that, to build a snug, which is the smallest building you can build. You need this is so cool. You need composite planks. And to get composite planks, you have to have Well, quite a few of each of the long are the short moonleaf, the regular moonleaf, and the long moonleaf boards plus, a few other items that are trade terminal and so forth. So it's, I did a whole video on that shortly after I bought this thing, and I managed to collect all of those ingredients for 100 attempts at composite plank. If I get enough requests, or any requests for that matter, I will edit and post that video on here. And in that video, I cover perception gains quite a bit, because the TerraTech, the personal harvester is the trick. You want perception gains, that's where to do it. You need to be level 6 in the harvesting skill, or the resource gathering skill. Sorry, which is, I always forget where that is. Not information. Is resource gathering. Here we are. Yeah, you need to be level 6 in resource gathering to use the PH3. So that's where I started. I had already attained level 6 shortly after buying my, or after getting to Calypso. I got there. And as you can see, well, now I'm level 11 in resource gathering. So that helped quite a bit. Attributes. Oh, I'm sorry. No, it's general, is perception. Yeah, I had six. I'm sorry, just shy of 800 points in perception, and I have 1300 points in perception. I thought I said 1400. I had 1300. That's pretty amazing. And because of the gardening update, and the huge markup in long and long moonleaf boards and medium and the mid-range moonleaf boards, I already paid this off completely. That's right place, right time, which is awesome, and I'll take it, because that's recognizing the opportunity and seizing the day, carpe diem, and that works. I think that's probably the biggest complaint a lot of people have about this game, is because the opportunity passes you by, and it shouldn't pass you by. You need to recognize it. I just happened to pick up my personal harvester before gardening update, which interestingly enough, I was, oh, hello. I was level 4 gardening. I think I'm level 6 gardening now, because the botany and all the zoology and all the geology and all the perception and all of the alert skill gains you get from using the personal harvester definitely worked out. So that's pretty cool. And I know I haven't made a video in a while, and maybe this is boring to many of you, because I didn't get a global, which I'll put at the end here. There'll be a little bit of music to it. Hopefully, I won't get in any trouble for that. Just, it's a short. We'll make it short. But I guess my big point here is, with the new update, come here to Fort Lahar, do the challenge. I'm sorry, the challenge. Do the cleanup. Get your 7 plates. This can help you in the battle against the robot incursion. I'm certain of that. And maybe you'll get lucky like I did and hit one of those big globals, or at least be part of a 1,000 ped, 1,000+ ped Hoff. And while you're at it, even if you're just a noob and you don't have and you're below level 6 resource gatherer, buy that trade terminal, personal harvester, and go out and harvest some trees until you get to level 6, and then buy one of these and keep going. It's unlimited. I don't, obviously the gardening update and all of the planks, the moonleaf boards, I'm sorry, have come down tremendously in price. That's pretty much why I'm going to post this video, because there's the competition is going to go back to normal. But that's the perception gains alone from your personal harvester are amazing. And I think I've gained from all of my skill gains using this TerraTech 2 hit points, and all the other skills I mentioned earlier. And I've had fun doing it the entire time. And I'm not in the hole. I'm not in the hole for buying it. I paid this thing off. I'm still in the hole. Of course I am. Isn't everyone? But it's a game, after all. And I'm accomplishing, you know, my Kerbro skill points. I got those delightful armor plates. And I'm alive to fight another day. I hope this is at least somewhat informative. And I'll throw the global little Thin Lizzy on the end of this. Shout out, we're going to lose this global, right? Well, it's been building on here for a while. Okay, never mind. There's a 34 peg global. That was what I was looking for. Maybe I spoke too soon. It's the Thin Lizzy limit. That really draws them in. It makes the curves more of a play. So you